everyone. Today I am going to teach you the concept of relational terminologies in unit 1st relational database management system. In RDBMS we will learn first introduction to relational database management system. What is database, what is database management system and what is RDBMS, and after that RDBMS terminologies. Now I start here to tell introduction about this topic. First, the world of data is consistently changing and evolving every second. Then it turns towards completely new dimensions of growth and challenges for a company around the globally. By accurately recording data, storing, updating and tracking them on an efficient and regular basis. A database management system stores, organizes and manages a large amount of information within a single software application. Database management systems are important in the business and organizations because they provide to us highly efficient methods for handling multiple types of data. Let us understand exactly what is meant by database. A database is an organized, a collection of standard information or data typically stored electronically in a computer system. Here I used the word structure. We know that there are two types of data. One is structured and second is unstructured. Now I discuss on data, structured data. As the word structured suggests, this data in which is highly organized and neatly formatted. Structured data is organized in tabular format, that is in rows and columns, and there is a relationship between different rows and columns. As such, it's highly organized and formatted and easy to store, process and access. It can work very easily with most standard analytical models. It also requires less storage space. Some example of structured data are Excel files, Google Sheet and traditional database management systems. Now we talk about the unstructured data. Unstructured data is a data which is not organized in any predefined manner. It can be textual, numbers, dates, binary large objects. It can be difficult to process and organize, which requires more storage and gives more freedom for the analysis, which tends to be complex in nature also. Now come to the point, a database is usually controlled by database management system. Together, the data and the database management system, along with the applications that are associated with them, and refer to a database system. Here we understand what is mean by database management system. Database management system is a system that is used to store and manage data. A database management system is a set of programs that is used to store and manipulation data. Manipulation of data which includes the following points. First is adding new data. Second is deleting unwanted data. And third is changing existing data. Here I taking an example of university management system. In this system, there is a number of modules or relations which are interconnected to each other. Okay. First, we consider add new data. Means you can add new student in the student table. Second, changing existing data. Means update operation. Okay. You can change existing data regarding the student. Then third, delete unwanted data. Means you can delete unwanted information regarding the such kind of a students, right? Here we will see about what is mean by relational database management system. Relational database management system means what? RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. Relational data is structured in database, tables, fields, and records. Each database management system table consists of database, table, and rows. As well as each database table row consists of one or more database table fields. RDBMS stores the data into collection of tables which might be related by common fields, means database table columns. RDBMS also provide a relational operators to manipulate the data stored into the database table. And last, I discuss here, most RDBMS use SQL as a database query language. SQL, the word comes from the SQL. Here we will see which kind of a relational terminologies used in relational database management system, in which relations, tuple, domain, primary key, and foreign key. These are the relational terminologies mostly used in RDBMS. Here I discuss first relational terminologies, that is relation. Relation is nothing but all data atoms and relationship among the set of attributes are represented in two-dimensional table. There are three components in which included, which are nothing but name, degree, cardinality. I am taking example of a student table here. Now one question is arising in your mind, why the number 343 is mentioned in front of degree, name, and cardinality? And the solution of this question is, name means column headings, right? Means student ID, student name, student age. We read as authentically student underscore ID, student underscore name, student underscore age, right? We can say also set of attributes means column headings. These are the number of attributes are present in the given student table. Now we turns towards degree. Degree means what? Degree means number of columns in the given table. Then how many numbers of columns? Number of columns are 3 again. That's why degree I mention here is the 3. Student underscore ID again, student underscore name, student underscore age. Then degree is 3. I mention here. And what is cardinality? Cardinality is number of rows, means total number of rows you are used or putting in the given table. There are 4 rows, means 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, Jay Shinde, and his age is 19. Up to 4, means 1 to 4. That's why cardinality I mention here is 4. Now I discuss here second relational terminology, that is tuple. In RDBMS, rows of relation is called as a tuple. Means we read as a student underscore ID 1, student underscore name as a Jayesh Shinde, and student underscore age as a 19. Up to one record, 4, 1 to 4, that is all over the 4 tuples, means total rows of a relation called as a tuple. Then third relational terminology is domain. Domain is nothing but collection of all positive values from which the values for a given columns or attributes. I taking single columns, namely student underscore name. Under this column, only names are present. Okay, means all information is in the form of worker only. Means data, worker data is the domain of student name column. Understand? Here I discuss on primary key and foreign key. Means what is the actual role of a primary key and foreign key in the relational database management system. Here I showing two relations, namely one is that student and second is course. Now we consider about first table, student. Student table containing three columns, means student underscore ID, student underscore name, student underscore age. In student table, I applying the primary key for a first column, namely student underscore ID. Let us understand what is exactly primary key. Primary key is a column or combinations of a column that is used to uniquely identifies each row in a column. See here, under the student underscore ID column, there are numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. None of the record is duplicated or redundant here, right? And now giving the information about the course table. In course table, there are four set of attributes, means four columns: course underscore ID, course underscore name, course underscore fee, and last column, which is coming from the first table, student table, that is nothing but the student underscore ID, which containing three tuples. Three tuples means three rows. We know that we called as a rows in a RDBMS language as a tuples. You observe why student ID column is come from student table in a course table. The answer is that it act as a foreign key. Foreign key from which table? Student table. Then foreign key is that a column or set of columns that refers to primary key in the same table or another table. Means student underscore ID, it is a act as a foreign key from which table? Student table. In, for example, we can say that in the student database, a student table stores student data with primary key column, right? Namely student underscore ID. It also stored student data in an course table which holds information about various courses and associated students. To link these two tables and determine student and their course is information, student ID column must be inserted in the course ID table which referencing existing student ID from the student table. In this case, the course table student ID column is the foreign key that references a column with the same name in the student table. This is an example of a relation between two tables, that is nothing but in between table student and course table, right? Thank you.